Find the impedance of the circuit shown in below figure. Assume that the circuit operates at omega is equal to 50 radian per second. It has given omega. Because to calculate Z, we require omega. Okay. So instead of directly giving the Z, he has given capacitance and inductance. So thereby we can calculate omega. Select, say, how do we start the solution? Solution. Let Z1 is, say, let me assume that Z1 as a impedance of 2 millifarad capacitor or impedance of C1. Then Z2, let Z2 is impedance of 3 ohm. And see, these there are two elements in series. One is 3 ohm resistor and another one is C2. So C2 is nothing but 10 millifarad. So I'll consider Z2 as the impedance of 3 ohm and 10 millifarad elements. Okay, 3 ohm resistor and 10 millifarad capacitor. And let us consider Z3 as it's an impedance of 0.2 Henry and 8 ohm resistor. Okay, so in that case, dear students, Z1 can be calculated. Z1 is what? 1 divided by J omega. Say it's the impedance of 2 millifarad capacitor, which is nothing but I'll write C1. This is equal to 1 divided by J. Omega is how much? It is 50. Say J into 50. Okay. So because omega is 50 radian per second, he has given into C1 is, it is 2 millifarad, 2 into 10 power minus 3, which is equal to, so this is 100 and this is, say, 1000, means it is 10. This is minus 1 by J is minus J and this is 10 ohm. Z1 is minus J 10 ohm. And similarly, Z2 is equal to, say it is 3 plus, both are in series, it is 3 plus J 1 divided by J omega C, because reactance of a capacitor is 1 divided by J omega C. Z is equal to 1 divided by J omega C. And this is equal to, this is 3 plus 1 divided by J 50 into 10 into 10 power minus 3, because 10 millifarad. And this is equal to, so you calculate this, it is 50 to this. Okay, this is 3 minus J. How much you get? 3 minus J. It is J2. Yes. 3 minus J2 ohm. Right? So, and lastly, Z3. Z3 is equal to, say it is, it's a Z3 is a series combination of L and R2. Say it's nothing but 8 plus J omega L. J omega L, which is nothing but 8 plus J 50 into 0.2 millihenry. And this is equal to, if you calculate, say how much you get. Say this will be 8 plus J 10 ohm. Right? Say omega L. Say it is 8 plus J 10 ohm. So this is Z3. And say important thing here, dear students, we can calculate Z. If you see, this is Z1, this is Z2, and this is Z3. Means this same equivalent circuit I can represent like this. Some Z1 here, and here, this is Z2, and here we have Z3. This inductor, and between these two elements we should, between these two terminals A, B, we should find Z in. Okay, Z1, say this is Z2 and this is Z3. So it is simple thing. Say how can I write say Z in? Z in will be equal to, if you see Z in here, this Z in is, it is equal to Z1 plus of Z2 parallel Z3. Z2 parallel Z3. Z2 and Z3 both are in parallel. To this parallel combination, Z1 is in series. Right? So now if you substitute Z1, Z2, Z3 that we have calculated. So Z1 is, it is minus J10 plus Z2 is, it is 3 minus J2 and Z3 is 8 plus J10 divided by, say 3 plus 8 is 11. This is plus J8, right? Say both the combination. And this is equal to, say now try to solve the students. If you solve this, take calculator and directly you can solve. I'll write here 3.22 minus J 11.071. And this can be written in polar form. So is equal to 11.5295 angle 73.774 degree. So this is Zin. Dear students, this is the second one. Find current I in the circuit of figure shown below. Okay, say here, if you see this, to find the current I, say the current I is this. This circuit has to be reduced. To reduce this circuit, look at this. Here there is one impedance. Here there is one impedance and here there is one impedance. Combined with 2 ohm and this is minus J4 ohm, say it can form one impedance. And if you look at these three impedances are connected in delta form. So we need to convert, say, this delta network to an equivalent T or Y network. Okay. So looking at this figure, say how to solve this, the solution. So our delta network, like say, I'll name this as A, this particular node as B and this particular node as C. I'll write like this, a delta network connected between nodes A, B and C can be converted to a Y network as shown below. So we can convert this to Y networks. For example, if I consider this at the center point, one element will come here, one element will come here, and third element will be here. Okay. So let us convert this. First, this will be as it is. 1 ohm. It is as it is. And here between, say this and this element, say there are two elements here. So one will be Z1 and another will be Z2. Here you will get Z1 and one more will be Z2. And between these two, you will get one more. This I call it as Z1, this as Z2 and this as Z3. See, one element here, second here, and third one is here, right? So this is Z1, Z2 and Z3. And this capacitance is connected as it is. Here, you have one inductance and one resistance. I just converted a given work or delta network to a equivalent Y or T network. This is 50 angle 0 degree volts and current I is flowing through this network. Now how to calculate this Z1 and Z2, Z3? So here I'll take up this and calculate here. If you see, Z1 is directly, look at this. Z1 is this 2 plus 2 minus J omega 4. This is actually Z1. Right? So, and this the combination Z1 will be converting delta to Y network. Say we can write this as J4 ohm. Okay, so like R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Say this I consider Z1, this as Z2 and this as Z3. Here Z1, Z2 and Z3. Z1 is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Just a conversion of delta to Y. Say R1 is like say Z1 Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3. Z1 is J omega 4, Z2 is 2 minus J omega 4, J4 divided by J4 plus 2 plus 2 minus J4 plus of 8. Say all Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3. And this will be equal to, if you multiply, this is 4 into 4 plus J2 divided by 10. And this is equal to 4 divided by 10 into this 4, 16 divided by 10. So this will be 1.6 plus of 0.8J. Similarly, now Z2 is equal to, now here, say this is something like ZB, ZC divided by ZA plus ZB plus ZC. Okay. So this is J4 into 8 divided by, directly I'll write this at 10, which is equal to, say this is J 3.2 ohm directly, because 8 4s are 32 divided by 10 is 3.2. Then Z3 will be equal to, it is 8, and another one is 2 minus J4 divided by 10, and this is will be equal to 1.6 minus J3 ohm. So dear students, just use delta to Y conversion and convert Z1, Z2, Z3. Okay. Later your Z will be equal to, say Z is given by looking at this diagram. What is your Z? So look at dear students, this particular Z3 and this, what is this? J6 ohm and 8 ohm, all are in series. And this series combination is in parallel with Z2 plus and this combination. What is this? Minus J3 ohm. This and this both are in parallel, and to this parallel combination, these two are in series. I'll directly write this here. If I write Z is equal to, it is, this is 12 plus of Z1, this is Z1, 12 plus of Z1 plus of these two combination, look at this, this and this, it will be say Z2, right, minus J3. This combination is in parallel with Z3 plus J6 plus of this 8. This is total impedance, right? So now only thing is we should substitute Z1, Z2 and Z3. So this is equal to 1 plus 1.6 plus J.8, that is Z1, and plus of, this is J.2 parallel with, this is 9.6 plus of J 2.8. So just substitute the values, which is equal to, so if you calculate this, it is equal to 13.6 plus J1, or in terms of polar form, it will be degree. This is Z, and what we are interested in, we are interested to find I. I is equal to, it is 50 angle 0 degree divided by 13.64 angle 4.204 degree. And this is equal to 50 divided by 13.64 is equal to, it is 3.666 angle, this is minus 4.204 degree ampere. Dear students, if you know the concept that is discussed for the DC circuits, solving AC circuit is not at all a problem. Hope this is clear to all of you. Thank you. Thank you for watching.